User exits. User exits or function model exits are exits developed by SAP. The exit is implemented as a call to a function model. The code for the function model is written by the developer. You are not writing the code directly in the function model, but in the include that is implemented in the function model. The naming standard of function models for function model exits is exit underscore the program name and then a 3-digit suffix. The call to a function model exit is implemented as call customer function and then you specify the 3-digit suffix. There's a special search function for each enhancement technique, which you can use to find the program exit prepared by SAP. You can use transactions CMOD or SMOD to look for user exits. Let's take a look at an example of a user exit inside the SAP system. So now, as a user exit example, we have the following case. So inside the SAP system, we have the transaction code VA01. That transaction code is used to create a sales order. So, you know, the common function of creating a sales order can be done inside the SAP system. For that, we use transaction VA01. And the requirement is that the screen field sold to party must display the code 200,000 as default. So let's go into the transaction to take a look at it. So let's type VA01, enter. Now, in the order type, we're going to type OR, that is the standard order type. We want to create a standard order. So we type OR and then we press enter on the keyboard. That takes us to this, to the create standard order screen. So here we have the field sold to party. And the requirement states that this sold to code must be always displayed the 200,000 code. Let's search, for example. We click on the search help, then we search again, and let's select this customer Acme. Double click, and that customer is the code we are looking for. So we want, whenever I'm going to create an order and I press enter, I want that code to be displayed here automatically. So we need to modify this SAP standard screen. Remember, this is a standard screen. So we're going to use a user exit. So first, we have to find out what program is this transaction assigned to. So how do we do that? Well, we go on system, status, and then we take a look at the program name. The program name is SAP, so I'm going to write that program name here, so we keep it as a reference. Now, I want to find out the package of this program. So I'm going to go back again, and I'm going to go to transaction SE38, the ABAP editor. And I'm going to go and click attributes and display. And now I have the package. So I'm going to write it down as a reference also. Package VA. Now I have to find the appropriate user exit for this program, this standard SAP program. So I'm going to go to transaction SMOD, go ahead and press enter, and now I'm going to go to utilities, there you go, utilities, find, and on package I'm going to write the package that I just found, and I'm going to run it. Now all these exit names are displayed, so I have to choose the correct one to display this value in this field. So I have to analyze each exit, but I'm going to analyze only these ones. Why? Because these ones are related to my program name. How do I know that? Because of the V45A, and that my program was V45A. So I have to analyze these four exit names. But so let me take a look at the short text. So this one determines the alternative materials for product selection. This one's predefined the sold to party in the sales document. This looks like the one I'm looking for. So I'm going to go ahead and double click this one. And then I have this function model, the exit, SAP, the program, and the three-digit suffix, remember? So I'm going to double click this one, and it's going to take me to the function model. So I'm going to write my code in this include. So now I already identify my function model, but I have to create a project to implement my user exits. So now that I have identified, I'm going to write it down. So my function model will be this one, and my exit name will be V45A0002. I need to keep that in mind. So now I go back to the SAP Easy Access menu, and then I go to transaction CMod. In this transaction, I'm going to create my own project to implement user exits. You can create different projects and activate or deactivate your projects and have different user exits implemented in the system. So I'm going to create my project one, and then I'm going to go ahead and click on create a short text. We can specify here, this could be, for example, project for user exit assignments. So I know I'm going to have this project for the user exit assignment. So I go ahead and click on save. I select my package, my ABAP course, and my request. Now I have my project saved. Now I'm going to click on enhancement assignments, and I'm going to write my exit name here. So I copy, paste my enhancement, and I press enter. This is the predefined sold to party in sales document, and I save. Now I click on the components, and then I can see that my exit is here. So I'm going to double click on my exit, and then I'm going to double click on my include. It shows me a warning, yes, so I press enter, and then it tells me this include does not exist. Do I want to create it? Yes, in my package. And now I can write my own ABAP code here. So previously I identified which was the field that prints to the screen the sold to party. That field is the econ number. So I'm going to assign to that field my value. So I save and activate my user exit. Now it is active, and I go back. I make sure this function model is active, yes, and then I go back one more time, and now I can see that this check is showed by the system. This means my exit was implemented, but this is still in red. I need to activate my program. So I'm going to click on change. There you go. And then I'm going to click on activate. So now my enhancement project was activated. I have to activate it so my ABAP code functions correctly. Now I go back. I activate one more time just to make sure. Yes, it is active. So now I can go back. And now if I go back to my standard transaction, as you can see, SAP is compiling the program because now it has a user exit implemented. Now the order type, remember I used the standard order and I press enter. And then as you can see, my sold to party for as a default value is the 200,000. So I modify the SAP standard without actually modifying its source code. I just used a user exit to implement my own code. So that's the way you can use user exits.